These are wrecked German planes. Parachute flares dropped on the harbor from an enemy plane seeking to locate the supply ships. Tracer shells go after them. This was a Junkers 88. Most of the bombs fell in the city. Stands for victory everywhere. The surrounding countryside is littered with the wreckage of Nazi planes. This is a Dornier. All that is left of a Messerschmitt. The crew of this one was captured. The final score, 14 Nazi planes shot down against a loss of 4 of our own. No important installation, and our tank convoy suffered no casualties. Convoy heads for the Tunisian front. American transport planes loaded with supplies follow us as we advance. East of Sukaras, the General Grants climb a range of the Atlas Mountains. Dispatch riders speed ahead. Here, the roads are hard and fast as compared with other sections of North Africa. Tanks keep 150 yards, presenting a difficult target for a surprise air attack. Whenever the General Grants come to a halt, camouflage is the first order. The difference between a good and bad job may very easily be the difference between life and death. Bedded down for the night. Always on the alert. This is what American paratroopers look like after jumping from a plane at dawn, deep in enemy territory, accomplishing their mission, and marching 30 miles overland in full pack under a hot African sun. Too. Transportation arteries open is of primary importance. French soldiers guard all roads, bridges, and strategic points. P-38 circle overhead, providing an aerial umbrella for our convoy. Take a good look, Yank. You better make sure. Daylight attack. The Nazis not only bombed the train, but repeatedly machine gunned it from a low level. Every car was plainly marked the Red Cross. Buying chickens from the Arabs. The Arabs at all times were most helpful in their efforts to provide poultry and green vegetables. You got it.